You probably sang along to a song or two by this next group. They've been called one of the biggest boy bands in history, exploding onto the scene in 1990.
And about 25 years on, wow, the British pop group Take That continues to draw huge amounts of fans wherever they go, including right here in Asia. And I sat down to talk to them about their past and also their future.
I guess now it's time for me to give up.
Welcome to Singapore,
thank
to Asia.
You.
Thank you so much for sitting down with me. Asia, it's been a while since you guys have been to Singapore, and fans are probably wondering, what's up with that? Why did it take so long? So tell me, I think over 20 years since you've been here.
It is, it's a good question. It has been 20 years since we played a show here. I think a couple of us have landed here on the way to somewhere, but actually to visit and properly see our fans and do some shows, 20 years.
But 9 of those years, we took a break. So, there goes 9. Yeah. Think about the 11 now.
And we came on holidays many times, but not together as a group. But it's very exciting. We've been out here now, and we would have done about a week on this trip all in all. And it's been really nice, and we've sort of fallen in love with the place, and now we're saying, listen, we've got to get back out here as soon as possible. Yeah. So,
well, let's talk about longevity, because like you said, you were on hiatus for about 10 years, been together about 25, and the music industry is so fickle. You can be huge one day, the next day no one really knows who you are. So what is it about your group that has stood the test of time?
I think one of the things is being starting at the right kind of time, which is in the 90s, when people really, you know, I think people still really love music, even more so than ever, but I think back then we were in the right place at the right time. And I think for us as well, it took us at least 2 years for us to grow as a band, and we made our way up by ourselves, and we didn't do it through any TV program. So I think that's one of the reasons.
Yeah.
There's many reasons, I believe.
A lot of luck, hopefully some good songs. I think two things that have sort of stood the test of time is the songs that were about back then, but you know, people have related to those songs, and I think our live shows as well.
And it's me you need to show, how deep is your love.
And of course, a lot of your staying power is because of your fans who have been with you from the beginning. You're in your 40s now. Your fans have grown up with you. They have kids now. They have kids like you guys. Can you talk about your relationship with your fans and what that's been like? Because I've seen on Twitter women flying in from the UK, from Australia, just to see you. And so much time has passed and they still love you.
It is amazing. And, you know, we feel so honoured to have been able to have this audience that they've basically grown up with us, and we've grown up with them as well. And it seems that whatever we do, they're still there for us. You know, like you say, we took a hiatus for 10 years, then we came back, they all came back and supported us again. It's been really incredible, the whole journey. And, you know, there's nothing more fun for us than to come to somewhere and play a live show and be able to play songs from the last 25 years. And it's really the soundtrack to a lot of those people's lives, so as it is ours. So it's a really positive, great, upbeat feeling.
Do your kids listen to your music?
Yeah,
they have to.
Okay, so you force them to listen, that's great.
Yeah.
Are they fans of other music? Do they say, oh, come on,
no,
Dad, you're not that big? Or
I've got a 17-year-old daughter, so she's, she's into all sorts. She's into quite grungy stuff, very guitar-based music. So, but they're very good when you're about to release an album or when you're writing songs. The great people to play the songs and say, well, what do you think of this and what do you think of this, you know? You got to get down with the kids, you see.
A lot has changed since you began your careers. Notably, social media has taken a hold. It's a different way to access music, access the artists. Has that been difficult for you to adjust to that and to become part of that social media world?
I think for us, as a music act, it's one of the best things that's ever happened, because, you know, rather than relying on a journalist or some critic to tell your audience whether your album's good or not, the people tell each other. You know, the people sit and they vote with their tweets and with their Facebooks or whatever they do. And so it really cuts out that middle ground. It means we can get straight to our audience when we want to tell them something, when we want to play them a new song or a new video. We have the direct link straight to our audience. So it really just takes out that middle ground, which is great.
So it's been easy to adapt to,
yeah.
You think?
I think Gaz has found it quite easy. Gaz is a bit more technological than some of us. We catch up. He comes into the room and he goes, "Hey guys, check this out," and he shows us what the latest gadget is and the latest thing. So yeah, some of us, I know Jason really wasn't into it, was he?
Yeah.
Jason goes off, when he used to go offline for like a year. I'm going offline for a year, so no emails or no, you know, and
that's
then
no
he come back.
Phone usually,
no
it?
Phone, yeah. No.
Wow. He used to bring on tour one of those dial up phones.
Yes. But I think, see, you know, between us it's okay because there's certain people who do it a bit more.
So that's a great segue because a lot of fans are wondering, okay, what is up with Jason and Robbie? They're not here, obviously, but what's the relationship like? How often are you in touch with them and has the dynamic changed because they're not part of the group?
The dynamic is always changing, I think, within the group. And since we came back in 2005, this is the third way we've been shaped, because Rob came back for a record. So we've sort of got used to where we are now. We're enjoying it as a group. There's talk of maybe Rob coming back and doing some of an anniversary that's coming up in a few years, which would be nice. And Jay wanted to have a break from the music. We don't know whether they'll ever come back or not again, but we sort of realised that the band now, we sort of have a revolving door, we always say. It's like a revolving door. People can come in or leave whenever they want, really. So you've just happened to catch us as a three. Okay. Tomorrow we might be a five. The day after that we might be a one. The day after that a three. You know, it changes all the time.
Okay, last question. So looking ahead, what can fans expect? Anything special for 25th anniversary, Vegas residency, anything that you could tell us?
Yeah, that's something we are looking forward to. It's the Vegas residency. We're going out later this year to look at the theatres and stuff. So that's something that's moving ahead, which is very exciting. And then, yes, the 25-year anniversary.
Next fall we think we're gonna, you know, do some kind of package which includes all the music for the last 25 years, which will be lovely, with maybe some nice pictures in there and maybe some new stuff as well to celebrate the 25 years and hopefully
also,
a tour.
And also this year we're recording an album this year and we'll probably have it released at the end of this year, so
much to look forward
to.
It's an exciting time, to be honest, to be in the band, because but sort of, we've got this little plan for the next few years, which we don't always have. I mean, they still have that mentality, we just take everything a day at a time, but it's kind of nice, you look ahead and you go, oh wow, we've got all these little things to look forward to.
Well, you're still seeing success and you're also lovely, so thank you so much for taking
the
time to
speak
to
us. Thank you.
Just unbelievable. Close to 25 years together.
Mm-hmm. They took a break for about 10 years, but still, they're back and stronger than ever.
And hopefully Jason Orange and Robbie Williams will hook up again after 25 years. We'll be good to see them now. Lots of things for fans to look forward to. The band was in Singapore for the HSBC Women's Champions Golf Tournament just last weekend.
Mm-hmm.
And full house, huh, when they performed.
Yeah, a lot of those fans, some of them at least, they flew in. I received a tweet from a woman flying in from the UK,
wow.
Some coming in from Australia. Their fans are really devoted. And actually, after that interview, I was with our producer, Dilla. She's also a huge fan, by the way. But we stepped out of the room and these fans swarmed them and asked for photos and pictures and autographs.
And the age variation from what, how old? They all in their 30s,
looked,
40s, some
yeah,
of them?
Yeah, they looked like their early 30s.
Okay, all right.
So,
well, fantastic.
Still.
Okay, so hopefully Jason and Robbie will join them when they hit 25 years next
Lance is
year.
Asking for you to rejoin the group.
Yeah, come on down.